we have the highest property taxes in the country. We've got the highest tax burden on small business in the country. We've got some of the highest in income tax rates, fee rates, etc. No wonder why people get all up in arms when they got to pay a beach tag and a $70 registration fee and all these things. I get it, and I don't blame you. What I'm asking you to do is stop getting angry at the little things. It's not about beach tags. It's not about car registration. It's about the big things. It's about the real estate tax rate is too high in most towns. It's about the income tax rate. It's too high across the state for high incomes. And the higher you go on the income scale, the more flexibility you have. You know, somebody said it earlier today. I don't know who said this, but I don't know if it was a caller or someone brought this up. It's a great point that so many, I think it was Greg in Freehold, actually, who brought this up. So many of these so-called rich people, they're not that rich. But they've got enough means where they got the condo in Florida. Maybe they got a condo on a golf course in Arizona. You know, maybe they got a place on the Barrier Islands in the Carolinas, something like that. They have an option to say, you know, I could live half the year there. And especially when you get people that are, you know, take an example. Somebody's like 55, 56, 57 years old, maybe almost 60. They've got 20 good years left. I'm playing the averages. And they're like, my kid graduates this year. I already got a condo in Florida. Why would I stay? Why would I stay? And that's what we have to be mindful of. So what's happening is David Matthau did a good report on this on the website that he reported on 6,000, 5,700, somewhere in that neighborhood, millionaires leaving the New York, New Jersey area. And we've done the studies. My friends at New Jersey Business and Industry, Michelle Sikirka has done an out-migration studies over the last couple of years and has identified literally billions of dollars running out of the state. So if you're a progressive Democrat and you're like all in for Bernie Sanders this year or Elizabeth Warren, that's fine. But understand that if you're a progressive Democrat and you buy into the talking point that we can't give rich people tax breaks, you have to understand that we're not talking about rich guys like George Norcross. That guy, I'm glad they're finally going to audit and go after whatever shenanigans were going on in Camden. There isn't anybody in New Jersey that doesn't think every I was dotted and every T was crossed. Pretty sure many of them were left uncrossed and undotted. So we'll see. We'll see. We'll let the Economic Development Authority audit go through. I think a judge will decide on that possibly today, and I hope they really do the audit, and I hope they really uncover what's been going on with these tax breaks. That's not who I'm talking about. I'm talking about the person who's defined as a rich person, the guy that owns the dry cleaner, the guy that owns the hardware store, the guy that owns the landscaping business and files his taxes personally on a small business and generates $1 million in income. That's the person that you don't want leaving. And if you say we don't want to give that guy a break because he's a millionaire, ask any of these so-called millionaires just how hard it is to survive in New Jersey. And it'll give you an idea of just how hard working class folks have. Why do you think I've been an advocate for government workers to get their pensions? Because I get it. I get it. Look, I come from the roots of spending my time as an 11, 12, 13-year-old working in my dad's machine shop. You know, my dad was a small business owner. And I grew up around the guys, you know, working these machines, coming home dirty. And I learned hard work at 12 years old. And I learned the respect that you have for working men and women who put in their 40 hours, sometimes 50 hours and longer, work weekends, and they're just barely getting by. And if you don't have an understanding of how tough it is at that level, and then if you're so blinded by how tough it is at that level, to then turn around and not understand that a lot of these so-called millionaires are actually working class people that employ other working class people. So what I propose is very simple. And if the governor, he's not going to come on. I mean, I talked to George Helmy the other day. I shouldn't say talked to. We exchanged texts, and he blew me off by saying, I'm going to pass this along to our comms guy. So which is political Trenton speak for the governor's never going to have the guts to have an actual conversation with you, which is fine. I mean, you know, whatever. But what I would ask Governor Murphy, on one hand, I would congratulate him for going after these bosses. I think it's about time. And he is, although an unlikely ally, he's doing the right thing. You got to go after him. All the bosses need to be gone after. Gilmore, he's done. He'll be going to jail. He's out. He was the Republican boss in Ocean County. Goodbye. Now you've got Norcross in Camden County, Democrat. If this audit shows that they screwed up with that $1 billion, goodbye. Then you got Sean Golden, who's double timing as the bully, the bully party boss, and the sheriff. I don't know how that's legal, but that aside, goodbye. His days are numbered, I'm sure, as well. So you look at this, you say, well, the people are coming back strong. So I'm going to give him credit on that side. But then on the other side, ask him, Governor, why not? Seriously, a serious question. Why not? Go through the talking points, still have your allegiance to Elizabeth Warren and Cory Booker and Bernie Sanders, but just look at it practically and say, listen, if we lower the tax burden on the so-called millionaires and double the number of millionaires, we're going to have a better, stronger tax base to give actual working class tax credits and tax relief. That's the solution. We need more money in this state, not less. It's pretty simple. But we got to get through the talking points on both sides of the aisle. 9:45 traffic.